So let us understand the GIMP window first of all. This is the title bar. This is the toolbox. This is the ruler. This is the toolbox actually. This hole is the toolbox. And this is the canvas. And this is the status bar. Let us learn them one by one. The title bar is also known as the emphasis bar. This is placed on the top of the image. So it shows the name of the image and some information. The menu bar will have all the categorization of different menus or operation. They are categorized in the various categories and they have all the operations that you want. Toolbox, this is, you can say, a floating dock where you have basic operations. Ruler gives you an idea of your pixel. This is pixel based, so it gives you an idea that on which image you are working, what is the length, what is the width, how it is going to be seen in your, say, website or some other way. Status bar, on the down part you have a status bar, so it shows you the things which are going on. I'll show you all these with practical example. And then we have a canvas. Here you actually do the work and you can go to different zoom level, and you have as I explained you, you have a yellow dotted line showing the image boundary against a neutral gray background. So before we go to toolbox, let me see whether our GIMP has opened up, and if it is up, let us see. So this is our GIMP. This is our GIMP. So what all we have seen is we have to make a new image. I can take, these are all my already made template. So I can choose any of this. Let me take 800 by 600. Say okay. So this is my image. This is a new image. Now you can do all those activities you want. You can paint, you can write your name, you can do whatever you want. Okay. And there are various layers also. Layering also can be done. But here, this is okay. So let me open an image which is already there. So let me go to open. I have an image. I'll go to that path because I have recently used it. I'll open it. This is a baby image. And since we have two images, it will open here. See, it has opened in another window. So this is a baby image. So I have two windows now. Now I do some activity, say some activity, and I just say file save. Now I can save also. Now while saving, it will ask you for different formats, and this you can go to different folders also, and you can save in different format. This is how you save and save as. Now this is the toolbar. This is the toolbar. Let me first make you go through the toolbox, then we'll come to the practical example. So this GIMP has a diverse assorted tool combination of tools. Rectangle tool if you want to choose a rectangle part. Oval selection if you want to choose a particular elliptical region. If you want a free flow selection like this, then you use the lasso tool. This is a fuzzy selection or a magic wand. So this will help you to select areas of current layer or image based on color similarity. So this fuzzy selection is all the similar color pixels will be selected. And this wand is quite good for selecting object with sharp edges. So these are all the possibilities, like the, I'll show you a few of them. These are all the possibilities. It depends on what kind of activity you have on the image so that you can use it. You can also select by color. So we have this magic wand, then you have select color tool. So you can, depending on the color similarity, it works like a fuzzy select tool. But the difference between the magic wand and this color tool is that magic wand will select the contiguous region, but this will take in complete image. If the similarity is here, it will take all into account and show it. So no contiguity is required here. It will take all those similarity, not like unlike the magic wand, which take only the contiguous regions. When we have text tool, we always want to write on the image. For that, we have text tool. We have eraser tool, something you want to erase. If you have done it accidentally, then this is erase tool. Bucket fill tool, you can fill the bucket with the foreground or background color. And you have a color area. I'll show you, there is a background and foreground color. So this is immensely used for painting, filling and various other operation. And you can just click on either of the color displays in the color editor block, which will permit you to change the color. Before going to the menu, let me take you to this some of the tools we'll see. See, I want to select this part, say this part. So I've selected a region. Now I want to do some activity. I can select a oval shape also. I can select a lasso also, this portion. Okay, this portion is selected, and then I have various possibilities. These are all the possibilities which I can do here. See, so this tool, as I just suggested, we are already explained. This is a fuzzy select tool. So it selects in the form of continuity, and we have other color select tool also. So you can do like this, select by color. So just taken from here also multiple areas it has taken. And you can shift the image if it is not good, like this. Shear, you can do the shear. You can do some other activity, like you want to write something. You just go increase the font if you want, and you can change the size, the font type also. Now the menus of GIMP window, as we see, we have various windows. So let us go back and let me just close it. And I'll open it again. So let me show you the windows, and this window will come. See, we already have image. So this is window. All these are there. So for what this does is, this file menu contains the most commonly used command related to GIMP file. Then we have the edit menu. This edit menu contains the command related to handling of information, like the cut, copy, paste, and there are other selection commands. We have image menu, so it contains commands that are used to edit the entire image or specific part of an image or active layer. Then we have editing the image. So you want to scale the image, you want to change the size of the image. Let us see about that. You just have to go to image and scale image and just change the size. I'll show you in practically also. Then you want to prepare the image. You can export the image in different formats. Now what you want to do here is, you want to export the image, but you don't want to reduce the pixel or width. You just want to reduce the size. This is also possible. I'll show you how. There will be a slider which will come. And then how to crop an image? You can crop a specific area. We have to go to tools, transform tools, and crop and resize. So we can crop a specific part of an image. This is the original image. This is the cropped image. Then the layers. So there are various layers. An image like the Photoshop you were working, there are various layers on which you can work. These are virtually stacked like this. So you can do the activity on this, you can do the activity on this, and you can just combine them also. And if you do some erasing here, this image will be seen. So before summarizing, let me show you some aspects. Let me open this image first. Okay, I have this image, or rather, let me close it and open an image, full face image. Let me open this image. Okay, now I have a full faced image. I want to crop it. For what I'll do, I have various options. I can go to the right click, okay, then image, and then crop to selection. Because I have not made a selection, let me make a selection. I'll make a selection like this. I'll go to the right click, image, and crop to selection. So this is cropping. I can even go to image and crop here also, crop to selection. Now I want to rescale this. So let me go to this scale image, and this is also possible from right also. See, image, and you might have scale image here. So both ways it is possible. Let me scale it to 1500, because the aspect ratio remains always constant. So it will scale it depending upon the aspect ratio, that is the ratio of width and height. This is how we scale it. And now I want to export it. I want to export it. And when I export it, say some other name, say photo one, I want to export it. But when I'm trying to export it, I just don't want that the key idea or key content I don't want to play with the content. I just want to have the size less, the byte size less. So this is the quality. You can reduce the quality. And now you can just make the image half. So just export it. And you see, if you go to that particular place where it is stored, it will be half of the size. So these are the basic editing which we can do. So let us summarize what we have learned. Image editing encompasses process of altering image. GIMP, this is GNU image manipulation program, free and powerful image processing tool, you can say, powerful open source image editing tool, you can say. You can retouch the photos, author the photos, compose the photos. You can have rectangle selection, you can have oval selection or free flow. This canvas is a part of image window that where the images will be displayed. You can have an open selection, you can select circular or elliptical region. We have a lasso tool for freehand. We have fuzzy this select tool in order to select area which are based on color similarity. You can place a text tool, you know, text on the image. Then eraser is also there. You want to remove certain area, remove certain part. Bucket fill is also there. This is showing the current and foreground color. You can take, pick one color and just place it at the selection. The color area shows the GIMP basic palette, which consists of foreground and background color that will be used for painting, filling and various other operation. You can crop the image. You can take specified area. Their layers are transparent sheets stacked on one over another. So you can see through the transparencies area, because transparency can be changed, and you can see the lower area and combine them later. So this is